Shri Gurubhyo Namaha, this is Lata here to continue with the second chapter, Principles of Management. Today, we will learn about FIAL's 14 Principles of Management. Before going to the details of Principles of Management, few lines about Henri FIAL. Henri FIAL was a French mining engineer. He is considered to be one of the person who formulated the Principles of Management. FIAL was first to identify four functions of management, namely planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. According to FIAL, all activities of an industrial undertaking would be divided into technical, commercial, financial, security, accounting, and managerial. He also suggested that qualities a manager must possess should be physical, moral, education, knowledge, and experience. Henri FIAL was considered as a father of general management. Children, FIAL's principle is an important topic to be considered for your board exams. And we have a project on FIAL's principles too. So, it is important to be thorough with all 14 principles of Henri FIAL. We'll move on with the Henri FIAL's 14 principles of management. First principle, division of work. Second, authority and responsibility. Third, discipline. Fourth, unity of command. Fifth, centralization and decentralization. Sixth, unity of direction. Seventh, subordination of individual interest to general interest. Eighth, scalar chain. Ninth, remuneration of employees. 10th, order. 11th, initiative. 12th, stability of tenure of personnel. 13th, equity. 14th, esprit de corps. When you list down the 14 principles of management, you'll be worried how to remember all the 14 principles of management. It is simple to remember when you be thorough with the statement which I've written here. Dad, UC, USSR, OIC. So when this first statement of DAD, D represents division of work, A represents authority and responsibility, D discipline, U unity of command, C centralization and decentralization, U unity of direction, S subordination of individual interest to general interest, S scalar chain, R remuneration of employees, letter O represents order, letter I represents initiative, S represents stability of tenure of personnel. E represents equity. E represents esprit de corps. So be thorough with this statement where it will help you to remember your Henri FIAL's 14 principles of management. For your better understanding, the first letter of each principle has been highlighted with a red color. Shall we move on to the first principle? First principle is division of work. According to the division of work principle, work is divided into small tasks or job. The job is assigned to each one according to his competence, qualification, and experience. When a person performs his part of work again and again, he becomes an expert in doing in that and his efficiency level increases. Thus, division of work leads to specialization. Say for example, if we need to supply 50 lecture stands to a school, one worker will cut the leg piece, other will cut the top boards, one will assemble them, one will give a polishing and another will give a finishing touch. With this division, each worker becomes specialized in doing his part of job and his effectiveness and efficiency increases. So we can say that division of work leads to specialization. Next principle is authority and responsibility. What do you mean by authority? Authority is a right of a superior to give orders to his subordinate and obtain obedience. What is responsibility? Responsibility means obligation to carry out an assigned job on time. If a person is given authority with responsibility, he may misuse his power. The same way, if a person is given responsibility without authority, he will not be able to discharge his duties since he does not have authority to command his subordinates. which in turn will make the subordinate ineffective. So it is important to see that authority and responsibility to go hand in hand. Say for example, if a worker is given responsibility to produce 100 units per day, then he must be given necessary authority to achieve this target. If he is not given authority to draw tools and materials from stores department, then he cannot discharge his duties. So it is necessary that authority and responsibility should go hand in hand. Third principle, discipline. Discipline means obedience, respect of authority, and going with the rules and regulations of the organization. Discipline is essential for smooth functioning of the organization. Discipline is not required only for the part of the employees, but also on the part of the managers. According to Fields, discipline requires good superior at all levels, clear and fair agreements, and judicious application of penalties. Next, we will move on with the fourth principle, unity of command. According to Fiol, there should be one and only one boss for every individual employee. This principle states that a subordinate should receive orders from only one superior at a time, and that subordinate should be accountable only to that superior. This will avoid dual subordination. Say for example, if a person receives orders from more than one superior, then he will be confused and will not be able to decide whose orders he must carry out first. If he performs the work allotted by one superior, it may lead to conflict among the superiors. Henry Fiol observed that if this principle is violated, then authority is undermined, discipline is in a question, order will be disturbed, and stability will be threatened. So it is important that unity of command should be followed, where there should be only one head and one boss for one employee. We'll move on with the next principle, is centralization and decentralization. What is centralization? Centralization refers to centralization of authority at one place or one level in the organization. Decentralization means dispersal of authority to the lower levels in the organization. So look into the diagram. It says it's a centralized organization where the important decision will be retained by the top level managers. See, in the decentralized organization, the picture says that the authority to make important decision is delegated to manage at all levels in the hierarchy. So the degree of centralization will depend upon certain factors like competence of the top management, ability of the subordinates, and the size of the organization. But the Fiol suggests that an organization should strive to achieve a proper balance between centralization and decentralization. We'll move on with the next, is your unity of direction, which says one head, one plan. All the units of the organization should be moving towards the same objective through coordinated and focused effort. It states that there should be one head, one plan for a group of activities having the same objective. Say for example, if a company is manufacturing motorcycles as well as cars, then it should have two separate divisions. Each division should have its own in charges, plans, and resources. The working of the two directions should not overlap on any account. So what is, and there comes an important question, what is the difference between unity of command and unity of direction? So we'll have the differences to be highlighted. Unity of command, an employee should receive orders and from be accountable to one superior only. So there should be a one person from where he will get the order. The unity of direction, one head and one plan for a group of activities having the same objectives. Here, it should be one head and one plan for the entire group. Second point, under unity command, it prevents dual subordination. Under your unity of direction, it prevents overlapping of activities. Third one, under the unity of command, it affects an individual employee. Suppose an employee is receiving an order from two superior, it is going to affect that particular individual alone. It is not going to affect your organization. But unity of direction, it affects the entire organization. Because when each department has its own plan and does not coordinate with the overall objective of the organization, it's going to be leading the organization in a pathetic situation where it will not be able to achieve your goal. So this will affect the entire organization. We'll repeat again. Unity of command, unity of direction. Under unity of command, one head with superiors giving orders to the one employee. Here, one head and one plan. Second point, it prevents dual subordination. So here, it prevents overlapping of activities. Third, it affects an individual employee. Here, it affects an entire organization. Today, we will start with six principles of Fiol's principle. We'll move on with the rest of the principles in the next session, where we'll start the next session with the subordination of individual interest to general interest. Thank you.